Good morning, everyone, and happy Easter. I'm Brad.
I'm Carol.
And we thought we'd start a little differently this service this morning with Carol and I reading the scripture passage of the day, which is John 20, verses 1 to 18. And the first piece that Carol is going to sing, When It Was Yet Dark, by Stephen Hatfield, the text is based right on the scripture reading. So we thought that would be a nice way to start. And then after Sherry's segment, Carol will close with In the Bulb, There Is a Flower, a piece by Natalie Sleeth. So this is John 20, verses 1 to 18. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him. Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes.
But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb. And she saw two angels in white, sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, Woman, why are you weeping? She said to them, They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him. When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for? Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away. Jesus said to her, Mary. She turned and said to him in Hebrew, Rabbi, which means teacher. Jesus said to her, Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God. Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, I have seen the Lord. And she told them that he had said these things to her.
Even women like me were fit to see. Happy Easter! Christ has risen. And on this very early morning day, I hope you are wearing a pretty frock. I am. This is as pretty a frock as I've got. Why should the boys wear all the pretty dresses? And of course, whoever you are, whatever you've done, whatever you've left undone, whatever you believe, whatever you don't believe, who cares? It's Easter. Life. We've come through the valley of the shadow of death. We know that the end of the journey is not death, but life. Let's hear the scripture passage. This is from John 20. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who reached the tomb first also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabuni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to God, but go to my brothers and say to them, 'I am ascending to God and your God, to my God and your God.'" Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen God." And she told them that he had said these things to her. Wow. So let's unpack that a little bit. First and foremost, who first was the witness to the resurrection? Mary Magdalene. Even in Matthew's gospel, it's the two Marys that come and witness the resurrection. It's not a man. It's not the disciples. It's Mary Magdalene. Mary Magdalene, who, you know, some traditions have said was a sex trade worker. Probably not so, but certainly a woman. So women were the first apostles and evangelists of the resurrection, and the first to see Jesus in John's gospel. And what's interesting also about this is she doesn't know who she's seeing. She doesn't recognize him first off. She thinks he's the gardener, which is such a beautiful, intimate image of Mary confronting creation, of Mary in almost what would seem a kind of dark version of the Garden of Eden. And she sees angels. She sees the whole panoply of what was present at his birth here at Christ's resurrection. So what do we get from this? First of all, we might not know Christ when we see Christ. We might see Christ in the gardener. We might see Christ in someone on the street, in a healthcare worker who's helping us through COVID-19. We might see Christ in the grocery store clerk who helps us get groceries. We need food to eat. We might see Christ in a first responder. We might see Christ in our neighbor who leaves something essential at our door. We might see Christ in those we live with this morning and celebrate along with this morning. We should go on a Christ hunt for Easter. Not a chocolate Easter egg hunt, but a Christ hunt. Where is Christ in our world? Where do we meet Christ? And of course, women can be clergy. Look at me. But more to the point, it's biblical. Women were the first priests. Even in Matthew, it's Mary and Mary who witnessed the resurrection. And of course, if you read the resurrection stories in the different gospels, they're slightly different because they're different vantage points. Humans wrote the Bible. Humans over hundreds of years, thousands in some instances, wrote what we are reading. We should be so thankful for those humans. So thankful for Mary Magdalene, Mary of Magdala. So thankful for her. So thankful for all the Marys of the world, those who tell us a miracle has happened, those bearers of the miraculous. So as we're living in a pandemic, this too will not last. The end of the story is life. The end of the story of death is resurrection. Happy Easter, everyone. Amen.